How you doing? We got Gordon Ryan here. Gordon, you ran through day one impressively, like you said you were going to do it. I want to ask you a little about it yesterday. You didn't show up, or you weren't at the lineup for the division. What exactly happened there?
Yeah, I feel like such an asshole. I made a post saying that I was going to be there to take pictures with everyone, and I just didn't. I just wasn't there. I had breakfast at the hotel yesterday after the because we had to weigh in 3 days. So we did the weigh-ins, and I went to have breakfast at the hotel. And I was feeling a little bit weird all day. And then like 10 minutes before we arrived to do the rules meeting, I like started profusely sweating. I got super nauseous. So the second I got here, I had to just immediately go to the bathroom and like stop myself from throwing up. I just like had to sit and stall until it was like. So then it finally like subsided enough to get in an Uber and go back home. I was like, I can't fucking do a lineup right now. I feel about to throw up. So I went home and I slept for like 10 hours. I slept from like 6 p.m. to like 4 a.m. And I was just profusely sweating the whole night. And I woke up and I was okay. I still feel like shit, but you know, hopefully it gets better throughout the day. So I didn't eat anything. I came to do the weigh-in. I was actually, because I sweat so much, I was like 4 pounds underweight. And then you know, I felt kind of shitty. My first match, I felt shitty, but I did a good job. And then
under 2 minutes, and this seemed to be like extremely quick. One of the fastest subs of the event so far.
Yeah. So I did well. And then you know, as the event went on, I started to you know, loosen up a little bit. My first match is always the worst. So I had like some anxiety about being like sick and about competing. On top of that, I haven't really competed in a big event since I hurt my knee. So it was like just a snowball of things that was going on in my mind. And then I kind of loosened up after the first match. And I started to feel a little bit better physically. So now I'm, you know, recovering. Hopefully I'm 100% by tomorrow. I haven't eaten anything today, so I'm gonna eat some food and see how I feel tomorrow.
What is your kind of game plan going into your last match and then going into the absolute tomorrow? Assuming you're planning on doing the absolute.
Yeah.
Do you have the same game plan, go in, sub everyone, or are you gonna look to do anything different tomorrow?
No, I'm definitely gonna try to sub everyone. You know, I don't really, this ADCC really isn't a success for me unless I have double gold with 8 submissions. Anything less than that really isn't. I'm gonna be kind of, you know, it's gonna be bittersweet. So I'm trying to get, you know, 8 submissions and, you know, the medal and the belt for the absolute title.
Awesome. After the ADCC, you are super active. I think you're booked for something every single weekend for at least the first couple weekends after
ADCC. I have 4 weekends in a row. So I have ADCC, and then next weekend I have Paul Harris for World Jiu-Jitsu Festival, and then I have Muhammad Ali for Fight to Win.
And that's actually in our hometown in Baltimore.
Yeah.
So we're going to cover that live as well.
That's awesome. And then I have the World Jiu-Jitsu. I have the World, or like King of the Mat Grappling.
Yep.
Sorry, King of the Mat Grappling.
Ohio,
yeah.
Right?
And then I have, later in the year, I have Adolfo, December 7th, and Gabriel Gonzaga, December 22nd. So, trying to keep active. I'm trying to make up for the first half of the year where I couldn't fucking do anything because my leg was broken.
You're really just trying to be more active and get as many super fights in. What's the timeline? How long do you intend to continue to compete into grappling as you kind of talk about transitioning over to MMA? Do you have a timeline for that?
No, I'm not really sure. You know, I just felt like I wanted to have the title of greatest of all time, Nogi, and I want to really solidify that before I, you know, at first I wanted to just prove that I was the best, but I want to be the greatest of all time and then start to transition over to MMA.
Awesome. Hey, Gordon, I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Of course. Thank you.